blocked. Another pass in front, knocked away by Robertson. Then the Leafs can't get it, and the shot is stopped on the short side, taken by Scheifele. Whoa! And then Robertson is filled in. And this is going to start a fight, and it's Morgan Rielly coming to his behalf. Nick Robertson got nailed at the blue line, and that prompted the retaliation from Rielly.
I don't know if there was a penalty being called on the play or not. But Morgan Rielly is going to jump in to stand up for his teammate. And the crowd in Winnipeg appears to be loving it. And if there's not an initial penalty, you wonder if Rielly may pick up the instigator on this. But right now, he's heading right to the
16:08, the time of the penalties.
And Nick Robertson starting up. And it's Josh Morrissey, he was the one that stepped into Robertson. And Nick Robertson made a good point. He said, I got to keep my feet moving. But this is now back-to-back games where sometimes you got to keep your eyes up ice, because he took some big hits in the game against Dallas a couple of times ago. And it looked like that Morrissey was, in fact, going to get a penalty for it. As we see on a back angle, the referee had his arm up in the air. Now they've got to try to decide if Morgan Rielly is going to get an additional penalty and keep things at 5-on-5 or 4-on-4. One thing we know for sure is they're both going to get a couple of
fighting majors, right?
Between them.
3 minutes and 52 seconds left to go here in the second period.
Now, last year, you may remember that Neil Pionk stood up knee on knee with Rasmus Sandin, knocked Sandin out of the lineup for a considerable period. Jason Spezza then went after Pionk and kneed him as Pionk was going down. Both players got suspensions without getting penalties on the plays that they were suspended for. And that's when Wayne Simmonds and Logan Stanley and everybody piled in later in the game. Rick Bowness, whatever the call is.
Rick doesn't look happy.
Rick Bowness does not like it, but Morgan Rielly is going to the dressing room. That doesn't mean he's out of the game. He's got the 5-minute major for fighting with 3:52 to go here in the second period. And we'll see if there's an instigator or not.
Oh, unfortunately, we cannot hear the PA announcements made since we're here in Toronto. So we're going to have to kind of guess at these until they're put up on the
interference
on the board.
I'm guessing interference is going to be the call. The puck was well past Morrissey and Robertson. And we're trying to get a sense from Sheldon Keith's facial expressions as to what the call might be. He's rather stoic. Wayne Simmonds is coming out for a skate now.
16:08, the time of the penalties.
I don't know if that means he's on the power play or...
Well,
just,
if he is, Kyle Clifford's on the power play with him.
Yeah. Maybe it's just the Lions coming out of the den to sniff around for a little while. But it does not look as though the Leafs are going to go on the power play.
And the draw won by Toronto, fed by Mete down into the Winnipeg zone. Along the wall, it comes up on the wing. Mete was able to block it there, but couldn't get it in deep. Now it comes back to the point. Kamp has control. Near side for Simmonds, trying to get it back. Kamp works in. Kamp goes around back of the net instead of shooting. Kamp with it again. Kamp run over there. Is that Stanley? I believe it was, yes, as the puck comes around to the near side. Kept in there by Giordano. Down into the boards, Clifford banging in there with Gustafson. At back of the net, Kamp intercepts, rolls it in front. Oh, chance there for Clifford, and that was stopped by Hellebuck. Jets back the other way. That might have been an offside, too, if this carries on. Pucking along the boards, bounces high. Maple Leafs can't get to it. Jets with it again as it comes to the point. Over on the left wing, it's knocked in. And around back of the net, Winnipeg controls. Knocked off stride there was Manalainen. And the Leafs get it up ahead. And things starting to get a little bit chippy here after they hit by Morrissey and the fight with Morgan Rielly. Long shooting goes down into the Winnipeg zone.
By the way, Morgan Rielly, unsportsmanlike conduct to go with the fighting major. That was the call.
All right. Sandin, far side. Into the corner goes Hall. Hall around to the side of the net. Stops. Flipped it back. Dished back for Matthews. High in the slot. Doesn't shoot it. Now he does. But he fanned on it and it went off the side of the net. Off a body. Back come the Jets in over the line. Drop pass to the right wing side. Closing in. Oh, what a chance Appleton had. Or was that Wheeler who cut across? It was Wheeler. Kept in at the blue line. Pionk getting it off the wing. Gets it to the far side. Wheeler went right across the face of goal and did not come up with any kind of... Now we got some more going on. Back of the Leaf goal. That's drawn everybody into it.
This time you've got the Matthews line on. And it's Rasmus Sandin that seems to be the most upset right now. Is that Pierre-Luc Dubois that appears to be in the middle of this as well? The arm went up, and I'm not sure whether it was a Leaf or Winnipeg player that was going to go. But you'll remember in that game last year when the Leafs were in Winnipeg, Pierre-Luc Dubois and Austin Matthews. I'd call it a wrestling match, but it was more like Matthews was being hogtied, but they both ended up with penalties in that game.
It appears that the Leafs are going to get a penalty and be a man short as
Perfetti. You know what? This should be evened up as well then. As Dubois grabbed Sandin from behind, then Bunting got grabbed. And we're still trying to... Now we're seeing highlights from a year ago that we've already described, haven't we?
Yes, we have.
Now, is this... No, this is last year's.
Yeah, this is last year. This.
But now they're showing the live shot of Simmons and Kyle Clifford over on the bench.
But the one thing you can say is that Sheldon Keefe has a good memory.
Yes.
Hence, Clifford and Simmons... Playing in this game.
Thank you for the cap space.
Yeah, and yes, exactly. And the other aspect of it is Simmons has created the go-ahead goal here in the second period with a brilliant pass.
Well, Kyle Clifford was a part of it, too, as the rush up ice.
Yep.
But we will see. I think, again, we're going to be... Oh, no, it is going to be a power. They got a Toronto power play on this? Wow, this is a... To me, this is a huge break for the Leafs. You can see it being evened up. As Sandin is the one that starts it all from the hip behind, then Dubois comes in and grabs Sandin. And does Dubois get the extra two in this?
I think he must have. Again, the...
Let's face it, the penalty, and it was a penalty, Rasmus Sandin, but it was very similar, or maybe not as drastic as the hit that Mitch Marner took in the first period.
So the Leafs on the power play, brought to you by your Ontario Subaru dealers. Round the boards, it'll come to Matthews, left wing side. Down into the corner he goes. Bank pass to the blue line to Sandin. Over for Nylander. Back to Sandin. Sandin to Matthews. Matthews down low. Marner. Marner looks across ice pass. Couldn't tap it home. Tavares was right on the doorstep. Nylander to Tavares. Return to Nylander. Nylander stiffening around, looking for man in front, goes back to the point. Now to Matthews. Matthews to Marner. Marner back to Matthews. Matthews to the far side. Sandin returns it. Matthews with a shot and traffic scores! Did Tavares touch that in front? I think he did. But a wrist shot from well out. And the Maple Leafs have a 3-1 lead here in the second period.
Well, if you go by the celebration, I think it is John Tavares who gets right in front of Connor Hellebuck as Austin Matthews drifts one from just inside the blue line, slightly on the left wing side. And Matthews, instead of the big windup, instead of the bullet, just the wrist shot that John Tavares is able to tip knee high and get it past the catching glove of Connor Hellebuck, and the Leafs are up two. And really got a huge break on the penalty calls to go on the power play.
Second goal of the game for the captain and his third of the season. And the Maple Leafs have a 3-1 lead. Puck goes down into the Winnipeg zone. For John Tavares, that is career goal number 394. And now 902 points on his career. As he is off to a great start. Centering pass in the goal crease. Knocked away, and the Jets are going to be able to break it out. Pionk gets to the red line and backhands it down into the Toronto end. Against the board, Sandin couldn't get to it. Deflected to the near wing. Leafs camp just trying to elevate it. A dozen seconds left in the period. And that is just about going to do it as the puck is well back in the Winnipeg zone with 5 seconds left. DeMello bringing it out. Played it up on the left wing. One last shot, but an easy save to add to the statistical information for Ilya Samsonov. And the Leafs will go to the dressing room up a pair on a couple of power play goals and a brilliant pass by the fourth line and David Kampf finishing it off.
And the amazing thing is that we talked about the hit that started it was Rasmus Sandin in behind the net on Perfetti. That wasn't even called a penalty, Joe, so that's even up, I guess, for the missed call on Mitch Marner in the first period when he was hit from behind.